That is somehow severely disturbing. Hey guys, this is Nathan, and welcome back to Hermit Pack. So in between episodes, I've been doing a lot of exploring. If we take a look at the map, well, we are currently underneath something, so we can't see it. There we go. So we already had this area up here explored. And Bloody the Great and I went south, and we found a desert way down here. Now you can see there's a large area here that has been disturbed. We mined out a huge amount of sand and sandstone, brought that back with us. And yeah, we brought back, I think it was like 2.5 chests worth of sand. And of course there's Wandering One. We're working on the spawn base here. But you can see we've got a lot of sand, we have a lot of sandstone. We also increased the size of the smeltery so that we can now smelt more items at once, which that's really helpful. Yeah, I will agree, we do need to label the chests. But yeah, we've been kind of trying to decide how we're going to lay out the map here. And one thing that we kind of decided was down here south of the base, the spawn base, we have this roofed forest here. And what we're going to do on this roofed forest is we're going to start cutting it down. And I think Craig has already started cutting down a bunch of it. And we're going to make the Batania, we're going to make this kind of the Batania area. And so we're currently working on getting a path down there. But we want to be able to get there a little faster, and so we're going to make ourselves another portal and possibly a simple nether hub. But we were also discussing about nether portals. And nether portals are really annoying. They're loud and you don't want to listen to them all the time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a bridge out here into the water, and we're going to make a platform out here in the middle of the lake and put the nether portal on top of it. So I made myself a chisel. This is a very easy thing to make. It's just an iron ingot and a stick. And I went ahead and chiseled up some oak planks. So we have these planked oak planks. You can see they have lines. Well, here, let's just lay these out. So we have the planked oak planks, I think those, you can see they're the same there. We have regular oak planks where they don't have the dividing lines. And then I think we should have some smooth oak planks. I thought we did. Well, here, let me do this because that wasn't supposed to be that. So we're supposed to have some smooth oak planks here as well. And so what we're going to do is we're going to use these three textures together to give a little bit of variation in the wood that we're using here. And then also we're going to be using spruce and oak to make the supports and things like that. Now, a trick that I have learned in the past, I used this in my original Wastrelcraft server, and I've seen a lot of hermits use it. You put something like spruce under the water, and then you put oak on top, and it looks like the water has soaked into the bottom log. It makes it look really neat. It's a heck of a lot better than just having it like this, where, yeah, that doesn't look as good as this. So we're going to be doing that. And, also we made some bags of holding. So we have plenty of room for all of the tools that we're using. We're going to go ahead and get rid of a couple of those. But so that's not the one that I wanted yet. I want the hatchet. And unfortunately, we can't auto-sort the bag of holding. But so I am going to do a little bit of work on this bridge and platform. And then we will go ahead and get ourselves into the nether and hopefully have a little bit of an adventure there. Okay, so I've got the bridge and platform for our nether portals built. I'm pretty proud of the way that it looks. You know, we got some cobblestone down the edge and I fall in a hole as I'm trying to look at it. That's real good. We got cobblestone down the edges with dark oak fences on top of that, the spruce down in the water, oak on top, and then we've got some slight variation in the top here with chisel, you know, making some great additions to the game. And we've got the portal set up here, and I'm joined by Wandering One, who just lit the portals for us. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and go through here, and we decided we were gonna do the Nether adventure together, so let's go ahead and go through and see what's on the other side.
Okay, we're not over a puddle of lava.
Well, that's good. What kind of block is this? This is another type of basalt. And we have regular zombies in here, so be careful.
Oh, wow.
They're inbound.
Okay.
Oh, what the? You hear these guys? What's wrong with them?
I was trying to swing for one, and you walked right in front of me.
Did you hear them, though? They're like, yeah.
I couldn't make out what they were saying, but yeah.
Okay, well, there's another one coming over here. Come and hit him.
Oh, and a blaze. So it looks like... Well, I'll go after the blaze.
So, here, let me turn off spawnable spaces. So... Should I? Here, I'm gonna mine a.
You mine? I will watch the zombie.
Nope, they don't care.
Don't care. Yay.
Well, that's good. And oddly enough, nether quartz gives us. Or nether lapis gives us straight lapis instead of giving us the. Oh, this gives gold nuggets? Weird.
Ooh, what is this one?
So that's kind of neat. So what do we got here? Ooh, this looks like emerald?
Nether diamonds. Nice.
Okay, well, I found some nether emeralds.
Nether is darker than I remember.
Ooh!
Do silver, I have my brightness up?
I have a silverfish.
Oh, no, I don't. I was in Moody. No wonder it's so
dark. Oh, wow. Silverfish dropped an iron ingot.
Nice.
So yeah, we're gonna have tons of gold nuggets here. I wonder which mod added that. I already have 63 nuggets. So do we want to try to find a fortress? I'd like to get some quartz. Myself.
I just picked up a little bit.
Okay, what was...
More gold than anything else.
Oh yeah, there's tons of gold here, but of course it's dropping nuggets. I wonder if fortune affects that.
It probably does. I've got fortune 1 on my pick I just made.
Yeah, I've got fortune 1 also. I'm trying to get it a little bit higher. So I'm grabbing quartz. I got some more lapis up here in the ceiling.
I see emeralds. Oh, there you are. You got a blaze.
Yeah, I'm blazing all right.
I'm charging him. And, oh, there's two of them. I'm stuck.
Well, I got one of them. The other one's too high up in the air, I can't reach him.
Yeah. I hit one. Now I'm down to, I was down to two hearts. Oh, crap. He got me. I'm dead.
Oh, yeah. You gotta make sure that your, your hunger is full. Putting your food on your, offhand when you're in the nether is a very good idea.
What the hell? I respawned and I'm still on fire.
Well, I killed him. So, you're safe
death
to come back
info.
In. Yep, I've got one of those, too, from falling into lava.
You just Does that go away, or you just store it somewhere?
Yeah, you can throw it away, or you can store it. Whatever you want to do.
Okay. I'm gonna need a pick to efficiently break my tombstone, probably.
No, it's on dirt.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna steal all your XP, though.
Oh, you bum.
It was one level.
That's all that was left, because I was up close to 20 range.
Well, it probably doesn't help any that I'm at level 25, so, or 24. There is a chicken flying around in here.
Cute.
Ooh, it looks like it's got an evil face. Ah! Yeah! It's an evil chicken.
An evil chicken.
I saw its eyes for a second. It is an evil chicken.
Oh. Here's some more. Get yet.
Yeah, that's cobalt. And I hear a ghast. And thanks to Tango and Impulse, now, from now on, whenever I see a ghast, I'm going to think I've got ghast.
I can see that. And I've never met you in person either.
So yeah, there's just tons of gold here. I have almost 4 stacks of gold nuggets already. Hey, that's my gold!
There's an incoming ghast. Oh, he turned away.
Well, here, let me try to take him on, because I've got the best chance with the least ping rate, so...
Do you have a bow or anything?
Nope, I'm just going to try to deflect him back. He's not shooting at me. He doesn't seem to care.
Oh.
Well, let's see. Will he come down low enough that I can just hit him? Nice! That was awesome! I hit him with the sword. He shot at me. Oh, another evil chicken. I'm going to see if I can... I think I got a picture of it running at me.
Whoa, something hit me.
It's an evil chicken.
I don't see anything.
They move really fast. Well, I only took about 6 or 7 screenshots. Hopefully one of them turns out. But I did get a ghast here.
Yay.
Mediocre efficiency essence. That sounds great. Oh, Blaze.
Okay. I'm gonna jump back to the overworld real quick so I can go help Gene with something. Oh, there's some chicken.
Eat. Quick, eat. There we go. Wow. That was a cheap shot.
Okay, so it looks like I am going to run to a... I may or may not be back on later.
Alright, well, thanks for joining me.
Yeah.
See you later. So, I definitely think it's time to add a little bit of nether quartz to our sword. Go ahead and fix that real quick. So, quartz, and more quartz. So, there's sharpness. Sharper. Nice. Sharpest. Oh, that's good. Sharp, sharper, sharpest. Of course, that makes sense. Okay, let's add some more lapis to the pickaxe. Okay, luck 2. So what do we got now? Luck 2, 244 of 360. We're getting closer. So, yep, we've got another portal now. We don't have to worry about long-distance travel once we get the portal on the other end. So, yeah, I'm going to get a lot of this stuff put away and figure out what we're going to work on next. So, the Nether was a very successful trip. We got tons and tons of stuff from there, and we will be working on getting a hub set up there for fast transport soon, but I was doing a little bit of work here and I kind of wanted to show this. So I've been doing a little bit of terraforming on this hill and I think that looks real nice. I did this path here. This wall originally was just dirt and I decided to change that to polished andesite. And so I think everything here has been looking really good. But as you can tell, I'm walking really slow and I can't run. So that is a little bit of a problem. We need to get some better food. And I think we're going to go the route of one of the items that I made in Crash Landing, which is the Delighted Meal. So for that, we need quite a few things that we don't really have set up for. The first one being cows that we can milk. So this is kind of a pain. We have to sit here, milk the cows, make cheese, milk the cows, make cheese, do it over and over and over. We'll try to figure out some way to automate that later on, but right now it's just kind of a pain. But so the next thing that we need is this toast. And we'll just come in here and we'll run backwards on it. So first thing we need is toast, a piece of raw beef, and a skillet. Well, the skillet is 2 pieces of iron, copper, or steel, and a stick. So we need to bake that first. So we need 1 stick. And a couple of copper is what we're going to use. So let's go ahead and grab 2 copper, and then we'll just go here, and there we go, skillet. So now we need a little bit of raw meat, raw beef. So we have a fair amount of raw beef. Unfortunately, we only have 16 bread or toast. So yeah, we're gonna need a little bit more of that, but that will make our hamburgers. So now the uses on the hamburgers, we want to make this into a cheeseburger. So we're going to take our cheese and add that to the hamburger. Now to the cheeseburger, we want to add lettuce and tomato and make a deluxe cheeseburger. So I have raised a whole bunch of tomato and lettuce, and so we're going to go ahead and add those, and we get our deluxe cheeseburgers. Now the next thing we need is fries. Now we have the deluxe cheeseburger, now we need fries. Well, fries take bakeware, salt, and a potato. Well, bakeware is 8 bricks in the shape of a furnace. So there's that. We'll go ahead and grab some potatoes because I got some of those ready ahead of time. And the cheese, I suppose, will drop off here in the meat. So we need a little bit more salt. So let's go ahead and grab a couple of these salt blocks. So we'll convert this back into salt. Do we have to set it down for that? Yep, okay, so that's unfortunate. So let's get a little bit more salt here. We're going to turn these potatoes into fries. So there's that. Now the last thing that we're in need of is the smoothie. So a smoothie is made with a snowball and the juicer. So that is a bit unfortunate. We do know where there is some snow, but we aren't anywhere near it at the moment. So yeah, that kind of stinks a little bit, but we will see what we can do. Now, the juicer, how do we make the juicer? I think it's just a smooth stone and a pressure plate. Yep. So that's pretty easy. We have everything for that, so we'll make up one of those real quick. Where is the smooth stone? We've been getting so much stuff, it's hard to keep track of what's what. So, there's our pressure plate, and there's the juicer. So now all that we need is to get those snowballs. So I think what I'm going to have to do is, I've got a little bit of the garden soup left. I am going to go up to the extreme hills to the north and get some snowballs, and then I will be back to finish off the delighted meal. So I've got my snowballs, and I think we're ready to do this. So we take our juicer, our blueberries, and our snowballs, and that's going to make some blueberry smoothies. So now we're going to take our blueberries, our fries, and our deluxe cheeseburger, and there we go, a delighted meal. So we've got 16 of those. That ought to last us quite a while. Now these have 18, there's saturation and there's the actual hunger rating. So the 18 will fill 9 of our hams down here. And then it has a saturation of 1.6. I'm not sure how that works, if that's 1.6 of each of the 18 or how, but yeah, it's a really good meal. I'm not gonna bother eating one until I'm almost starving. So I'm gonna set a few of these over here to the side. Now, we do still have a lot of the stock here, and we do have some other uses that we can do with this. But I'm going to have to kind of look through that myself, because I don't know what we're going to do with it for sure. But so I think I'm going to continue working here on the outside of the base, try to make it look decent. We've got a lot of torching to do over here in the swamp. I actually had a creeper come in from the swamp, go over the edge of the wall, and blow up the path right as I was finishing it up. So I really don't want to have that happen again. So I'm going to do some work on that. I'll give a little bit of thought to what more we can do, and I'll be back after I get that finished. Well, I have been placing out torches for quite some time. I think I've run through about 12 stacks of them. So if we take a look at the map, we can switch this over to night mode, and then you can see where the torched areas are. And I mean, I torched all of this area out here. I double checked a little bit around the area that we're going to be using for Batania. We've got out here into the swamp, did a whole bunch up here on top of the spawn base out in this area. I mean, it's just a huge amount of space that's been torched up, and it looks like we've got a path running further south from the Batania area. And then I know that Wandering One ran a path through the hills over here. So yeah, we've got a lot of stuff over there, but I'm looking here, and you know, a lot of this area is fairly flat. It may be elevated, but it is fairly flat. But we have this big hill here, and I don't really want it to be cut down, so I have decided that this is going to be the future site of my spawn town base. So we need to go through here, chop down these trees, and oh, we missed a spot. We need to go through here and chop down all these trees and get a layout of the land, kind of decide what it is that's going to be built here, and then I will come back and we'll take a look at that. So what I've decided I want to do up here is I am going to make like a Roman villa. And what I'm thinking we're going to make it out of is sandstone for the walls and probably some type of chiseled nether brick for the roof. But as I was cutting these trees out here, I happened to come across this guy. This is a little owl. I have no idea what mod added this. I don't know for sure what good they are. But yeah, it's just cute. So what I'm going to do, I am going to kind of make a preliminary plan as to the size of this villa. I'm going to have to level off a little bit of the top of this hill, and going to want to put a path coming up the side of the hill. Now that's going to be a little bit more difficult because of the simple fact that this is so steep. So what we may have to do is do like some switchbacks coming up the side of the hill, and we might be able to do some minor terraforming here just to make it look a little bit more presentable. We can't just make a straight shot up this thing because, well, it just wouldn't look very good. So I'm going to do a little bit of planning on that and a little bit of leveling here. And I really think we're getting close to running out of time, so this is probably going to have to wait for the next episode. So what I'm going to say is thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to give a thumbs up. If you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. If you have any thoughts or any tips or anything that you'd like to see me go into, be sure to leave that down in the comments, and I will see you next time. Bye!